Gillette Shave. And at our factory in Boston, 1,200 workers are starting their day building on over 100 years of heritage and innovation. Today, we're bringing you America's number one shave at lower prices every day, putting money back in the pockets of millions of Americans. I'm proud to bring you Gillette Quality for Less, because nobody can beat the men and women of Gillette. Go to GilletteOnDemand.com and get your fourth order free. Gillette, the best a man can get.
NBC News Radio. I'm Lisa Carter. Tropical storm Irma is grinding its way north after slamming Florida. The Florida Keys are cut off from the mainland, and officials say there is no electricity or running water there. Governor Rick Scott saying this afternoon it will take a long time for his state to recover.
I know for our entire state, but especially for the Keys, it's going to be a long road. There's a lot of damage.
Scott warning that Florida's biggest threat from Irma will be rising rivers, especially in northern Florida. He is urging residents to exercise patience while the state recovers from the statewide storm. He also praised the efforts of local, state, and federal agencies in responding to Irma. White House Homeland Security Advisor Tom Bossert lists the federal government's top priorities for recovery.
We are worried about flooding, housing, debris, and power restoration.
He says residents who evacuated should not be in a rush to return home. Millions are still without power in Florida. About a million outages reported in Georgia as Irma moves across the Peach State, the Carolinas, Alabama, and Tennessee with heavy rains and high winds. Forecasters with the National Hurricane Center predict Irma will be downgraded to a tropical depression on Tuesday. On this 16th anniversary of the 9/11 terrorist attacks, President Trump says the U.S. and the world were forever changed by the carnage on U.S. soil.
This is an occasion that is extraordinary, and it'll always be extraordinary.
Trump marking the terror attacks at the Pentagon this morning. In Pennsylvania, Vice President Mike Pence marked the anniversary, saying America will not rest in the global fight against terrorism. In New York, families of those who died at the World Trade Center gathered for a ceremony. The death toll is up to 9 after a shooting at a football watch party in North Texas. Plano's police chief says the person died at the hospital following last night's shooting at a home. He also says the suspect had a relationship with the people in the house. You're listening to the latest from NBC News Radio.
This segment of broadcasting brought to you by Tender Hearts TLC Incorporated. Tender Hearts, the helping hands for your loved ones, where they understand it can be difficult to find time in your already busy schedule to attend to all the needs of your aging loved one. Tender Hearts will be there for your loved one when you can't be. Tender Hearts TLC helps your aging loved ones stay in their home as they specialize in tender, loving, 24-hour service, including transportation to doctor's appointments, medication reminders, meal preparation, light housekeeping, and assistance with activities of daily living such as hygiene and grooming, orientation, and companionship. We thank Tender Hearts for their support of this station, Tender Hearts TLC, where they don't just care for your loved one, they give them tender, loving care. For more info, you can reach them at 909-528-9759. That's 909-528-9759 for Tender Hearts TLC.
When I say Italy, what comes to mind?
Venice. Capri. Oh my gosh, Capri was marvelous.
The views, the cliffside views, or traveling to Sorrento.
Pirello Tours.
Oh, Pirello Tours, for sure.
Pirello.
Hi, I'm Steve Pirello of Pirello Tours. With over 70 years of tour experience to Italy, it's no wonder Pirello Tours is synonymous with travel to Italy.
I think of the culture.
And to walk up to certain areas and touch a wall and think, well, this wall's like 3,000 years old.
Being on a Pirello Tour on our anniversary was better than anything I can remember ever on an anniversary.
I personally approve every itinerary to ensure a stress-free, once-in-a-lifetime vacation.
Salute!
Call now for your free insider's guide to Pirillo's Italy. Call in the next 30 minutes and qualify for a $100 gift card when you travel with us. Call 800-561-3095. 800-561-3095. 800-561-3095.
You're listening to KCAA, your good neighbor along the way.
The views of the following show are not necessarily the views of broadcast management or its owner, Fred Lundgren. But then again, the views of broadcast management are, well, different. And now it's time for On the Mark Live with host Mark Westwood. Finally, a show about KCAA. Hot topics, a little locomotion, current events, news, laugh, reviews,
and a little irreverence, and you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, 3, 2, 1, Mark.
And ladies and gentlemen, here we are once again. Happy Monday to you. Mark Westwood on the radio with you. 3:07 or something like that here. And looking out, the skies looks a little bit humid, tricky out there. But nonetheless, not too warm, I believe. I think it's in about the 90s or so. So meanwhile, kick back in your air-conditioned car, in your house, put your feet up on the sofa and relax. We're going to have an interesting program for you today on the Mark. Today we welcome Scott Welsh, who's a friend from the Redlands Chamber of Commerce and owns Welsh Insurance Services. And it has been declared one of the best insurance companies by the 2015 Reader's Choice Awards. Congratulations on that, Scott, and welcome. Yes, welcome. Scott is president-elect of the Redlands Chamber of Commerce, and we like to have him here because, he's an old radio guy, too.
I am.
He is.
Got my start 25 years ago in Riverside.
Riverside, yeah, yes. But I had to turn your microphone on for you.
Oh, that's good. It's good to have a microphone. Microphones are good.
It's a switch on those microphones. So once again, welcome and welcome Thank back you. To radio. You're back in radio just for a little bit this afternoon.
Yes.
And we're glad to have you here. And mainly we're going to talk about an interesting subject. And some people confuse it with Obamacare. It's not. It's called Medicare. And Scott Welsh through Welsh Insurance Services here just a stone's throw outside of our studios. Over on, what was it, Colton in Alabama. He has his offices there, and he has a lot of answers for you about Medicare and how you enroll in that. And there's just so much to talk about. If you are what age do you get to enroll?
65 plus. You're eligible at age 65 and or after you retire. If you are receiving benefits through your employer, that's okay. You don't have to enroll, but you're eligible at 65.
Yeah, eligible at 65. Now, not to be confused with Medi-Cal. That's something totally different.
Completely different health system, but they do work together. Mm-hmm. Medi-Cal is based on income for some folks that have lower income, mm-hmm. but Medicare is available to everyone.
To everyone, but you got to be a certain age, which is 65.
That's right.
And one of the questions I had earlier before we started this whole thing, because, you know, it's easy to confuse this with, you know, the national health care system, the Affordable Health Care Act, also referred to as Obamacare or Medi-Cal or any of these other things. And the insurance system is so confusing for everybody that some people just shy away from it. So that's why I thought it was important to have you on here today. You can offer your services, make people aware of who you are, comfortable with who you are. You can answer some questions. But, you know, one of the things that, you know, confuses me about this whole thing is, okay, well, who pays for this?
Great question. And you're right. There's a lot of information out there about healthcare in general and how does this affect me and what do I do and if I'm retired or where does it all start? So we'll start
from
the
beginning. Does this cost like $500 a month or whatever? Yeah, that sort of thing.
More good questions that, mm-hmm. that we'll certainly get to. But to begin, the program started in 1965. And it was eligible, and it was funded.
So way before Obamacare and the whole Washington debacle. Okay.
Yeah, way before. Obama was just a wee lad in 1965, I think. Mm-hmm. And so, yes, started to deduct a tiny little amount from each paycheck.
I just flashed for our readers. I just flashed three fingers up because I was 3 years old.
You were 3 years old.
Okay, go ahead.
I was one. I was what in 65?
Oh, so. Wow, so I'm older than you.
Yeah, way older.
And neither one of us qualify yet.
Well,
okay.
That's right, not for a while. But it's good stuff. The news is pretty good when you get there. So mm-hmm. 1965, they started to deduct a payroll tax deduction, and that fund has grown into trillions of dollars in the Medicare Trust Fund. So many people ask, okay, where's this money come from? And I always reply, it's your money.
So that's like my 35-cent deduction on my... Yeah, okay. Tells That's you how it. Much I make. That's,
yeah. Depends. It's yeah. all relative.
Yeah, right? It's all relative, right? Okay, but it's just a little tiny deduction for most people. Even if you make a lot of money, it's not very much.
That's right.
Because it's over the years. It's like Social Security. So, folks, take advantage of this because you pay for it, right?
You sure do. You have paid for it.
Yes.
You've paid for it your whole life. Mm-hmm. And many of the people that were enrolling today, if they're turning 65 now, they were born in 1952, which means they probably started working after 1966 or 67. So they've been paying for it their whole life. It's their money.
Now, some people under the age of 65 have some disabilities. They can get them qualified, right?
They do that. So Medicare and Social Security systems were set up in tandem so that they can help care for some people with certain disabilities. And if you are deemed disabled by the Social Security Administration for 24 months, in the 25th month, you are automatically eligible and enrolled in Medicare.
Now, that is a good thing. And you have different parts of Medicare, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, you know, I don't know.
Yeah, HMI. No, so there are really four main parts of Medicare. Mm-hmm. And there is a red, white, and blue card that says that this is a federal health insurance
program. Yeah, my parents
program.
Have those, yeah.
My parents have that. And that's where it starts. And that's what's known as Original Medicare. And on that card, you'll see Part A and Part B. Mm-hmm. And Part A covers hospitalization. So, and there's no cost for that, meaning you don't pay a monthly premium. There's nothing that comes out of a check for you or that you need to pay for Part A. It covers an entire hospital stay, but there is a deduction that happens with that. There are some costs involved in Medicare. It wasn't intended to cover everything.
What's the average deduction on something like that?
Well, the deduction is there's a number, and it's $1,316 for a hospital stay. So quick example is that you go in the hospital and you're there for 10 or 12 days and it's $50,000. Medicare Part A covers all of it except for $1,316 this year. That's the amount for 2017.
So some people get like a supplemental with that. Is that what they do?
Or? They do. You can put something with it. Mm-hmm. And then that $1,316 Part A deduction happens. You pay that and then you are covered under that deduction per benefit period. And what that means is that if you go home, you're discharged, you go home from that hospital stay, and 60 days elapses, then it starts over again. You may have to pay that again.
Oh, okay.
So technically, you could pay that several times during a year.
Yeah, that's true, because I know a lot of people that, you know, get sick, they get out of the hospital, they go back in, but not usually 60 days apart. That's a pretty good length of time.
It is.
You know, most of the time they go back in, it's 2 or 3 or 4 days or a couple of weeks later. And then there's Part B?
And then Part B covers all of your medical services outside the hospital. So primary doctors, specialists, labs, x-rays, therapies, anything that happens under the direction of a doctor outside the hospital is covered under Part B.
Okay. And then you have the other two letters in this whole thing are C and D?
Our Part C is a Medicare program called the Medicare Advantage Program. And that's what Part C is. And Medicare is a federal program. So it's the same for everybody from San Diego, California to Portland, Maine. But the Medicare Advantage plans, it's where Medicare works with many and different carriers, and it's based on where you live. So it's a geographical zone, and if you live in and usually it's separated by counties. So in this area, for instance, Riverside and San Bernardino County are put together for the most part, and plans work within those two counties. But Medicare Advantage covers everything. So it covers your hospital, it covers medical services, and includes drug coverage.
Pharmaceuticals, so expensive. Very
absolutely. So that's a big thing. Under Part B, however, just the original Part B, go back to that red, white, and blue card that we talked about in the beginning. Under Part B, there is a monthly premium that you pay back to the government. And it can come, you can pay it as a premium if you're not receiving Social Security benefits. But if you're receiving Social Security benefits, it's very conveniently deducted from your Social Security check. And so, as we talked earlier, Medicare wasn't intended to cover everything. And that's where that sort of 80-20 that you may have heard
80-20
happens. So what happens is that you pay your monthly premium, and for most people, it's based on income. So if you're a high income earner, it can be more, but for most people, it's $134 this year per month. It may be less for some people who've been in Medicare. If they were in Medicare prior to 2016, enrolled in it, it could be less. But for people who enrolled this year in 2017, that monthly premium is $134.
And that covers 80% basically of your costs?
That's right. And that covers about 80% of your medical services. So what happens after you pay that premium is that there is a $183 annual deductible. So you pay the first $183 for all of your doctor services. Mm-hmm. And after that, everything is 80-20. After that, you are responsible for 20% of everything.
Right, right. And so you get sick, you go in the hospital, your hospital bill is $50,000. Easy can happen. I know that for sure. And then you have to pay $183, not too bad a deal. And then, you know, you're covered for 80% of that. And hopefully, pray to God, you have a supplemental or you qualify for Medi-Cal or something. Can you qualify for Medi-Cal, be on low income and get Medicare?
Absolutely.
At the same time?
You bet. They work together. Mm-hmm. But to answer your question, the hospital, remember, is all covered under Part A. So Part A would cover that. Your hospital stay from the time you entered covered all of your room and all of the doctors and labs and x-rays. And if you needed surgery, covers all of that hospital stay, that entire $50,000, except for the deduction of $1,300. Could be. Depends on where you're. Private room someplace.
I don't think they give you a private room. Yeah.
But then when they discharge you from the hospital and you go home and then you see your regular doctor, you go back to your primary doctor, your specialist, whoever that is. Let's say it's an orthopedic issue and they require that you have or you require some therapy. That's covered under Part B. All of those visits outside the hospital.
Right. Which brings you to the 10 Part C, what is this? We represent 10 Part C Medicare Advantage plans.
Yes. There are many, many companies. In fact, there are 16 companies with well-known names in the area that are involved in that Part C Medicare Advantage plan.
So you're 64 and a half, you know, how do you do this? Do you go down to the Social Security office or apply? Or we just find somebody like Walsh Insurance Services, right? And you help them out.
Well, I'm a little biased, but yeah, I think that's the best thing to do. But actually, yes, it's good to have someone. The thing that we get the best feedback on is that it really helps somebody walk through, you know, sometimes you need a little bit of extra help to understand how it all works.
Oh, yeah, it's confusing.
It can be very confusing.
Don't be humiliated by that because, let me tell you, it's government. You know, this is a bill that was passed probably in 1965 that had 1,500 pages in it. And it takes the experts, you know, time to scrutinize this, go over it, argue back and forth, hearings, trials to come upon all these things. And this is why you need somebody like Scott here to do this.
Thanks. And yes, it's true. It can be confusing, and it doesn't discriminate based on your education level, your economic level, wherever you are. It's all challenging. So Medicare is actually, it's a good program. Mm-hmm. I know it's not always popular to say that, but the federal government has it together. There are many options for you to utilize your health care benefits when you turn 65.
Once again, not a part of the old snafu that's been happening in Washington, D.C. We heard about, you know, the Congress back and forth 50 times or whatever, trying to get rid of this or that or add this, or not a part of Obamacare, not a part of the Affordable Health Care Act. Totally separate. You pay for it. It's already paid for most of us, already paid for. Now, is there a threshold which it kicks in and it doesn't kick in? Say you're somebody who only worked part of your life. Do you get it anyway?
That's a really good question. It's a smart question because, yes, if you have to have, in order to receive Social Security benefits and or Medicare, full Medicare benefits, mm-hmm. as we stated with the premium, with the deductions that we talked about, it requires 40 quarters or 10 years of employment. Mm-hmm. So if you're employed in this country for 40 quarters, and those can be split up. You know, there are many.
You're there and there full-time?
And some stay-at-home spouses can receive Medicare based on their spouse having worked.
Oh, okay.
Been married, and so, which was another smart thing, because we have, you know, many domestic stay-at-home moms and or dads that are eligible through their spouse, and that's okay too.
So the earliest you can apply for Medicare is 65. Now, can you apply for it later? Some people are going to have to work later nowadays. So 65, 70, 75. Is there a cutoff in which you can apply for Medicare? Like,
no.
You're too old for it.
No, actually, great question. In that you may enroll at 65, but you're right. We see people every day that are working at 66, 67, 68, 70. I had a lady who was 72 years old and had been a nurse for 50 years. And God bless her. She deserved to retire and do whatever she wanted to do. So, yes, you may enroll at any time. And as soon as you know that you're going to lose your employer coverage, that's when you might come to see somebody like myself to help you walk through the process of enrolling in Medicare and in Part B.
So say you're one of these people that's kind of crazy, that wants to keep working. You know, you don't want to sit at home, and you're pretty physically able, and you're blessed with a good constitution still. Is there, like, can you earn too much money not to qualify for Medicare, or is that not true at all?
No. In fact, the way that it works, however, if you are a high earner, you may pay a little more for that Part B premium. So remember, Part A, you don't pay anything for. Mm-hmm. To the government. Part B, you do pay for.
That's the $134.
That's right. That $134 is for anybody, if they're single, up to $85,000 in income, or as a couple, up to $170,000. If you earn more than that, then your Medicare Part B premium can go up, will go up incrementally. So between $85 and $102, it's a little bit more. It's, you know, about $20 more and can go up more. So to your point, yes, you can enroll at any time and at any income level.
Well, good. To hear that, honey, you don't have anything to worry about. Gosh. No, but these are questions that a lot of people have, and I'm hoping I'm asking questions that are like that. You know, ARP, United Healthcare, Aetna, Blue Shield, HealthNet, those are all the insurance companies that are private providers that can work as a supplemental.
That's right. This is a good
example.
You're
going to need a supplemental. Everybody needs a supplemental.
You do. If not, you can actually go with and not be penalized. So if you don't enroll in Part B, for example, when you're 65 or retired, you don't have to enroll in Part B if you're still working. Mm-hmm. And you alluded to that earlier. If you're still working, you don't have to do any of this. You can wait until you're 70 or whatever age you want to. There's no increment.
Provided your health care, your employer has health care coverage.
That's right. And they call that creditable coverage. It's credited against your Part B premium. So you don't have to pay that Part B premium. You can start at any time. So that means that you don't have to pay your Part B to the government. And, you know, some people pay some of their employer income.
You know, I know there's a lot of questions asked, and I have a lot just comes to my mind. So you're 63. Should you start applying? How long does this process take? Can you just wait till you're 65 or 64?
You can enroll any time up to the month that you turn 65, and you can do that simply by going online. We can help you do that online. You can go into a Social Security office, which is not usually a favorite thing to do.
No, say that again here real quick. You can apply anytime up until you turn 65?
Well, without any penalty. So let me explain
this. Any penalties. Uh-oh, penalties.
Let me explain this. There is a window when you turn 65 if you don't have employer coverage, all right? So let's just say you're on your own. You're retired. You retired at 62. You are independent, and you are just
fine. In business for yourself.
Paying for your own health insurance, and you know that you're going to be eligible for Medicare when you turn 65. There is a seven-month window which you can apply. You can apply 3 months before your birthday month, 90 days, your birthday month, and then the 3 months after your birthday month. So that's a seven-month window which you can apply. And any one of those helps you avoid a penalty. There is a penalty if you don't apply for Part B when you're eligible. So if you go 90 days or 3 months after the month of your birthday when you turn 65, then there's a small penalty. It's about 10%. And it's 10% of what the current Part B premium would be. So if you sat out a whole year, it's 10% of that 134, so it'd be about $13.40. But if you sit out a whole year, they tack that on every month. So you pay that penalty every month for life. So when you weigh those things, you go, yeah, it's for most
it's
people,
strange.
It's a
they
good
charge
idea.
They a penalty for not signing up.
It's true. They want everybody to enroll and be taken care of and stay healthy and take advantage of the benefits.
I guess. It's just, that's hard to imagine. $13 a month that it can accrue if you don't sign up for it by the time you're 65.
And more.
Now, you're 65 and you just need to work a little more. Can you just sign up for it then not take it? Or
No. In fact, you don't have to sign up for it and take it if you're still working.
Oh.
So if you're still working and you're receiving employer benefits, remember we talked about that.
You have to be covered somewhere.
That's right. You have to be covered through them, and that through a group plan of some kind. Mm. And so if you're actively employed and you have healthcare benefits, for the most part, that's credited toward your Medicare. You don't have to enroll.
Well, I'm learning a lot today, Scott. We're talking with Scott Welsh from Welsh Insurance Services, who is the president-elect of the Redlands Chamber of Commerce, a former radio guy who will always radio in his heart, I know that. But it's been always a pleasure having you, and I want to keep talking with you. I just want to reintroduce to you to the listeners that may just be tuning in.
Well,
because
thank you.
You know how the 15-minute quarter-hour maintenance works.
I do. My attention span's about a minute and a half, if you ask my wife.
He's got AQH attention span.
That's right.
Yeah, working in radio, you know what an AQH is.
That's right.
But anyway, so you may be a teacher, and you get CalPERS, or you get CalSTRS. How does that work?
Very good question, in that there is an offset for your Social Security through those two entities. Mm-hmm. However, I've not found anyone that has not been eligible for Medicare through those two programs. And some people say, okay, look, I've had CalPERS, so I've not paid into Social Security, so wait a minute, you're okay. I haven't seen anybody that just has not been eligible for Medicare because of that, and rightfully so.
Right, that's a good thing. Or you're a veteran.
You're a veteran. If you're a veteran, you know, the VA and Medicare are the two largest health systems in our country. And if you're a veteran, thank you for your service to our country, and you receive VA benefits, you can have VA benefits and have Medicare benefits simultaneously. You have the best of both worlds.
You can go to a
absolutely
doctor. Sometimes the VA gets a little backed up. You can go to your Kaiser or wherever you want to go.
That's correct.
That's
you can good. Do both ways, and you deserve that, and you will not lose that.
Oh, that's a good thing to know. This is encouraging stuff here, folks. You know, I did not know the difference between all this until Scott stepped into the door. I'm so glad we invited you here today.
Finally, some good news.
Finally,
from
some good news.
Federal government, right?
And that's something right. That's like, wow, something that's working. Why is it working? It's because it's been around for a while and people have left it alone.
Two good statements. You're right. And that as long as they leave it alone and it's, you know, it's got 20 years of solvency, at some point there has to be some cost sharing. And that's the way they look at it, in that Medicare wasn't intended to cover everything, just as Social Security wasn't intended to be your full retirement plan. It was intended to help. And so as we've, you know, gone on with entitlements, is sometimes seen as a bad word. This is an entitlement you paid for. This is your money.
That is a bad word for a lot of people. This is something you paid for. This is you earned. This is your money.
That's right.
This is your money that you earned. So I hear about this annual enrollment, October 15th through December 7th.
It's right around the corner.
Right.
It is the annual open enrollment, October 15th through December 7th. What that means is that if you're currently on a Medicare plan, one of the Advantage plans, or a Medicare supplement, and I'll talk a little more about the difference between when I have choices, what do I need to do? But no matter what you have, October 15th through December 7th, you can make a change. Mm-hmm. So once you are in a plan, and the plans, by the way, always go from whenever you enroll in them to December 31st. If you enroll in a plan during this open enrollment, it will begin January 1st and go through next December 31st of 2018. And so that plan, and you're locked in. Mm. If you pass December 7th, you're locked into that plan for next year, whatever company you choose. There is a disenrollment period. And what that means is that if you enroll in a plan during open enrollment before December 7th, and then something happens, your life changes. Things happen. You have
things
from January
happen.
1st.
Yep, that's right.
That's right. January 1st through February 14th, Valentine's Day, in order to disenroll from that plan and go back to original Medicare, and then you can
that's
may
kind of
choose
a neat thing, because you decide to switch it up and decide, oh, I'm into this, and then you decide you don't. Well, maybe I made a mistake. I'm going to change my mind. You can go back up until Valentine's Day.
That's right.
That's very, very good. We've been talking with Scott Welsh of Welsh Insurance Companies about Medicare, a very, very important thing. One of the Inland Empire's best insurance companies, rated by that.
Thank you.
Rated that way. It's not just something he declared. And we're going to talk with him a little bit more after the break, with your permission.
Fantastic. Love to stay.
And before we go to break, though, in case you can't stick around, ladies and gentlemen, There's a website we could probably go to get in contact with Scott. Can you tell us about it?
It's welshadvantage.com. All one word, welshadvantage.com.
W-E-L-S-H advantage.com.
That's right.
And or you can text is that 648-1991?
That's it. That's an old number.
It's an old number.
That's right.
And we know where it came from. Anyway, you could text Scott, because a lot of people have smartphones, and it's a 909 area code. 648-1991. We'll be back with more on Medicare and Scott Welsh right after this.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, K292 FQ Riverside, and K293 CF Moreno Valley. For several years, KCAA has been marketing the Youngevity brand of nutritional and personal care products. Our experience with Youngevity has been 100% positive, so we are pleased to recommend them to you. Regarding nutritional supplements, we recommend Pollen Burst in the berry flavor and Tangy Tangerine 2.0 in the tablet form. For regularity issues, we recommend 3-Day Cleanse, and for personal care, we recommend Morning Hydration Cream. You can shop online for Youngevity at www.kcaateam.com, or you can order by phone by calling 800-982-3197 and tell customer support that you are part of the KCAA team. Youngevity is an American company based in San Diego. Call Youngevity at 800-982-3197 and ask about monthly auto ship that allows you to buy Youngevity products at wholesale prices. That number again, 800-982-3197. It's time to shop in the cool, relaxed comfort of the Tri-City Shopping Center in Redlands, conveniently located on the I-10 freeway between the Alabama and Tennessee exits. Bring the kids, too, and watch them play in the only indoor fun center, High Five Indoor Playground, where parents are welcomed on the playground. Birthday celebrations are encouraged, so make plans for some great summer fun at the mall. More reasons why the Tri-City Center is called the Mall with a Heart.
Hi, I'm Dr. Bob Marshall, PhD, host of Healthline. Tune in to get your questions answered.
Thank you, Dr. Marshall. And now introducing Quantum Nutrition Labs D3 Gold. 1,000 milligrams per serving, no artificial flavors or colorings. Buy one, get one 50% off. Call now, 888-588-7578. Or visit us online, qnlabs.com.
Teamsters Local 1932 proudly supports and sponsors a night of action-packed boxing. It's 911 First Responders Fight Night, Fire versus Police, and Guns versus Hoses. Saturday, September 9th, 7:30 p.m. at the Citizens Business Bank Arena. Tickets available at cbbankarena.com. Sponsored by Plumbing Master, UFC Gym, AT&T, Giant RV, and Corky's. Event proceeds go to Christmas All Year, a nonprofit charity created to bring gifts to underprivileged children throughout the Inland Empire. That's a night of action-packed boxing. Police versus Fire, a night of action, sponsored by Teamsters Local 1932. For more information, log on to kcaradio.com. That's kcaaradio.com.
You're listening to KCAA, your good neighbor along the way.
And now it's time to batten down the hatches, because here comes more of Mark Westwood and On the Mark Live. 3, 2, 1, Mark.
KCAA, 1050 AM, 106.5, 102.3 FM. All those wonderful trio, trifecta of talk, we call it. And, you know, batten down the hatches has been a good thing to say this week, I tell you, for sure, out in Houston, Scott.
Oh, it sure has. What a mess. But yeah, thankfully.
Houston and then Florida.
Yeah, and it's still going on. And poor Houston didn't get a lot of coverage in the last week because of Irma.
And they needed it. They needed it.
They sure did.
Definitely did. And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, if you're just joining us, we're talking with Scott Welsh, who's a friend from Radio Days back in the day from, well, we'll say it, 99.1.
Yes.
KGGO.
It's okay to say that.
I used to work there, too. Yeah, it's not competing. They do music. We do talk. And we're all friendly around here anyway, right?
That's right. Absolutely. Great. Had great friends and loved working there. Love the people I work with.
Robert Topping's already been over here from COLA. You know, we share engineers and everything else. It's not as brutal as you think. Anyway, Wells Insurance Companies, we've been talking about something really spectacular, folks. It's not political. Whenever you bring up healthcare coverage and medical, it seems like it's political. And the refreshing thing about this today is it's not, because Medicare has been around since, what did you say, 1965, Scott?
1965.
Right. And, you know, so this is something you pay for. It's not a part of healthcare system, Affordable Health Care Act, or the what people call Obamacare, or whatever national system they're trying to get together. It's not a part of that. It's just separate. It's been around since 1965, and it does cover you once you're 65 years old. And that's a really good thing. And I got to ask a question, and you probably can have one answer for me, if you know what's good for you. How the heck did a radio guy get into insurance sales?
Oh, one word answer, you're right. My wife.
Sarah.
Actually, Sarah started this business. And
that's your healthcare coverage, because if you know what's good for you.
That's right.
I mentioned that.
That's right. For my own health, absolutely have to mention that. Now, my wife, it's wonderful to be in business with her and to do something that we both really love. And we actually get along really well doing this. And we're sort of yin and yang.
Oh, that's a good thing.
She's brilliant at Medicare law and policies and procedures, and has really helped me. And I can ask her a million dumb questions, and she has to answer me. She's my wife, right? And so,
do you have like insurance pillow talk?
We actually do. Believe it or not, we sometimes have corporate meetings over coffee in the morning.
She says, is that your deductible?
No, that's right. Is that all your deductible? Right. And so, yes. Yes, we do. And it's a terrific thing that we can share. And it's great that we have this. And we have really, you know, two minds are better than one,
fantastic,
as they say, or one and a half in our case, at least, with hers being full.
The women are always more smart.
It's true.
If we know what's good for
them. That's right. Absolutely right.
But she is, did you say that she's very versed in the legal side of Medicare?
Well, she really understands and has a really strong understanding how it all works and all of the procedures. As we talked about earlier, this is very confusing. And for many people, there are so many little things that do you have to know. And she has it really. She is just so very smart. And coupled with the fact that there are many and different carriers, and each one of them have their own benefits. And so it's a lot to handle. That's why it's good to have somebody. We believe that it's good to have a broker like mm-hmm. us. We're both completely independent brokers. So, you know, the disclaimer is we don't work for Medicare. We don't work for any one of the health plans. We don't work for any of the medical groups. We work with all of them.
And so you already pay for this. So the beautiful thing about this, Scott, is, you know, some of the most popular people I know are like life insurance salesmen. You know, you find one that's like within 3 feet of you, you like run the other direction because you know you're going to get, it's like Amway or whatever, they're going to sell you this, you know, whole life or term right. life insurance. You're like, oh my God, here we go again, you know. But you're not that way, because this is something you already paid for. You're actually just a resource that people go to help them enroll.
That's a great way to look at it. In fact, I don't know if I wrote that down, but I will. Mm-hmm. I will write that down. You're absolutely right. We really consider ourselves one of the trusted resources that you may have in your life. You know, you may need a lawyer. Hopefully you don't have to use them very often, but you want to have somebody who's good in accounting and finance and a financial advisor. And we feel like someone who can be a healthcare advisor for you when you turn 65, so that you don't have to worry about it. Life is complicated enough not to have to worry about all this stuff.
It's like painting your house, okay? I can paint my house. I can do a pretty darn good job of it. It'll take me a while. It'll be a lot of effort. I'll be sore. I'll be banged up. I might not get it done completely as good as a professional. But I can hire somebody to help me get through that job. I can relax. I can sip a cocktail. I can, you know, look and see what a great job my house looks like, and it's all painted up, and I don't have to worry about it. It's the same way with this.
You're right, except that I won't charge you a dime. Your painter still costs you. We never charge for our services. Our services are completely zero cost.
How the heck do you make money?
Well, here's how it works. And full disclosure,
how do you make our money?
we are paid by the health plans that we're contracted with, 10 different companies, and we're paid by them, and it's an amount that's set by Medicare.
This is beautiful. So people can walk into your office. They don't have to worry about, like, a lawyer where the clock is going tick, 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 and you're like, oh, my God, don't talk to me for another 15 minutes. It's going to cost me $300. No, it's not like that.
That's true. You can stay as long as you want, and you can call and ask as many questions as you like, as often as you want, until you feel comfortable with them. We'll never ask you to buy anything. We'll never charge you for any of our services, and we really like that. For us, that is very fulfilling, that we can still make a living out of it. We're completely unbiased. There isn't one plan that pays more than another in order for us to there's no incentive for us to do one over another. We're really going to find out what works for you.
They're not
based on your
you.
Circumstances.
They're not selling Medicare to you. That's the beautiful thing about it.
That's it.
They're not selling Medicare to you. So again, you know, your website is
WelshAdvantage.com, and that's WelshAdvantage.com.
Right. Not the way they spell the jelly, but the other Welsh.
That's right.
WelshAdvantage.com.
That's right.
And the number to dial or text is 909-648-1991.
Or Sarah.
It's kind of fun to say anyway.
That's right. Or Sarah at 909-520-8482.
520-8482. And you got a big year coming up. You're going to be president-elect of the Redlands Chamber of Commerce in 2018.
Yes, thanks for asking me that. Yes, really proud member of the chamber and director, and it's great to have you folks in town now. KCAA is new to Redlands, and so welcome. And to be able to enjoy many of the services that the Redlands Chamber has to offer.
We love being here. We heard about your orange ball drop at midnight on New Year's, and we're hoping that maybe we can get involved in that.
Absolutely.
And we've had a few of your members in now interviewing them. This is what this Mondays at 3 o'clock is all about, is bringing in Redlands businesses, spotlighting them, highlighting them, getting people to know about them, being part of the community, and it's the give back to Redlands. It has really been nice. We've been welcomed very nicely into Redlands. We feel sheltered now.
Yeah, good for you.
And they were wonderful at City Hall. It's just like we went, did that happen? You know, we went to San Bernardino City Hall, just going to be a little political. And it was just like red tape. We're back, and then we go to Redlands, we're like, okay, bat down the hatches. Here we go. We got these documents, this. We walked in, and we were in and out of there like in 45 minutes, and everything was cleared. I was like, whoa, this is great. This can't be. This is going to be a catch. There's going to be a catch here sometime. It just really hasn't been. It's just been a pleasure. We're loving being here in Redlands. The weather's good. Well, it's good.
Good for you. It's the same weather, but it's nice. And, you know, it's really nice. And thank you for the plug on the chamber, because this really is a wonderful business community. A business community that looks out for one another. I've made so many friends and had such a great opportunity to learn so much about other people's businesses, about what their challenges are, and to find ways to help them make it happen. And, you know, somebody said, you know, we're stronger together. And that's not a political statement. That is really a good business statement. And we all look out for each other and take care of
that's
each
what
other.
It's all
and,
about.
It's good. And I love being able to do business. So many great local businesses. And we really want people to shop local and to look at that. That's really, when you think about what a community is, it's really one of the parts of the lifeblood of a community, and what makes a community special are its small businesses.
Yeah. And, you know, KCAA is now Redlands based. Our transmitter has always been in Loma Linda. So, you know, we're happy to be here. I think that things are going to go well for us here. We've been here for just a little over a month now, and we're really liking it. And I already tell you, I've attended 2.5 chamber meetings, and they were fun. They were fun. The people were fun and very delightful. So if people want to join the Redlands Chamber of Commerce, if you happen to be a business person or a small business person,
RedlandsChamber.org. Fantastic. We would love to have you involved and love to have you call and ask questions. You can call me at any time. And I've had a chance with the current president, Todd Underwood. We've taken upon ourselves to go and just meet people in the downtown area and all over town. We've probably met with over 50 businesses just to ask them how it's going and whether they're a member or not. If they're not a member, we'd love to see them and get in and participate with it. There are over 600 businesses that are members. And what a lot of people don't understand about the chamber is that it's a member organization. We are there at the leisure of our members. And so we want to direct things. We don't necessarily direct policy. We are asked to have an opinion on it. That's good. We are representative of our constituency, and those are the business owners in Redlands.
Member-driven, just like the Automobile Club.
That's right.
It's the Automobile Club for businesses. And there's lots of networking and opportunities that you can take advantage of, services, resources. Resources is a big word for me that helps you along in this world. And there's so much of a truncated process as a small business you have to get through, just like Medicare. You know, it's great. I would not have had Scott on here had I not gone to a chamber meeting, met Scott, and was impressed, brought him back here, started talking about Medicare, and today I have learned volumes about Medicare and what it's about and the differences, and now I can talk a little bit about A, B, C, and D, and, you know, $134, and, you know, A is all hospital coverage, and, you know, you're covered 100%, and B, you have a little bit of a deduction, and it's 80-20, and you can get a supplemental, and, you know, all these wonderful things, and that there's a service like Wells Insurance Services that you're doing, you and your wife are doing. What a wonderful thing, and you're helping people.
Well, thank you so much, and you've got it down already. You're a good student. You had it pretty well. You really did a great job of recapping that. That's exactly what it is, and I think it's, you know, it's just important to know that there's help. There is help out there. And not everybody, even though you know, what we hear constantly is that people are inundated with mailings, and there are, you'll see TV advertisements, and everybody wants your business. It's good to have that person to just help you wade through that pile of stuff that you're getting. Mm-hmm. Seems like the more information you get, the more confusing it can be. For me, it was like algebra. Seems like the more algebra I learned, the more confusing it got, and I needed help. I definitely needed somebody to hold my hand a little bit to get through some
algebraic
of that.
Algebraic challenged. I still am.
But that and Medicare, I think, are kindred spirits, but it's good to have somebody just kind of walk you through it and help you make decisions that are going to be best for you. People always say, okay, what's the best plan? Tell me what's best. And the reality is, and it's not, and we mean this sincerely, it's not about what's best. It's what's best for you. And everybody's a little different. Everybody has different needs.
It's not like going to buy a car. It's not like buying a car. You're not going to have this salesman pressuring you, putting you in a room and saying, "Here, you're going to choose. I thought you had to choose between A, B, C, and D." No, you can, you know, and the resources and the information, and you're not getting charged for them directly by Scott and Welsh Insurance Company. They're, you know, so there's nothing being sold here.
That's
the wonderful thing about it.
Your
Scott,
choice.
It's been wonderful to have you once again.
Thank you,
WelshAdvantage.com, WelshAdvantage.com. Very interesting. You can also, you know, refer back to us, KCAAradio.com, and we'll direct you back there. And the numbers to dial or text, 909-648-1991, because texting is a big deal now. People like to text.
Even 65-year-olds text.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes I can't even hold a conversation on the phone anymore. They're like, text me. Anyway, 909-520-8482.
Yep, that's
for Sarah.
Mm-hmm.
And Welsh Insurance Services, the Welsh Advantage. Thank you very much, Scott.
Thank you very much for having me, Mark. I really appreciate it.
Thank you. KCAA 1050 AM, 106.5 and 102.3 FM. We'll be back right after this.
You've been listening to On the Mark Live with Mark Westwood, a show about KCAA, the world, and you, with more to come in a moment.
This is Dick from Carpet Masters. Carpet Masters has been serving the Inland Empire for over 60 years. We are locally owned and operated by the Stevens family. We not only clean carpet and furniture, we clean many loose rugs, including Oriental rugs. Oriental rugs are cleaned in our modern facility where the fringes are cleaned by hand, then hung in our modern facility to dry. We do not use steam cleaning to clean your fine furniture. Furniture is cleaned by hand using the same absorption cleaning used in the White House. Some furniture we bring into our plant to clean properly. We normally use two men on each cleaning job using the extraction method. There is nothing that will clean carpet better for our customers. Our job is to clean properly with quality first. Google Carpet Masters San Bernardino and give us a call or go to carpetmasterssocal.com.
Look around your office. Is it time to change things up? Start a new home office or reorganize your professional office space? Visit Office Furniture Outlet in Corona and you'll feel great. With a huge inventory of both new and pre-owned office furniture, you can buy, sell, or even trade to get the job done. Office Furniture Outlet in Corona will get you looking and feeling good, and that simply means success and great business results. From executive office collections to home office options, you can find exactly what you need at an affordable price. Office Furniture Outlet. They have desk selections that range from modern and contemporary to traditional and elegant. With a large selection of sizes, finishes, and styles, you can design an office just the way you need it. An office you can be proud of. The Office Furniture Outlet in Corona is just south of the 91 Freeway in McKinley at 284 DuPont Street. Or visit OFOUSA.com. That's OFOUSA.com for the Office Furniture Outlet in Corona today.
Mark Christopher Auto Center presents the Vehicle Upgrade Event. That's right. It's time for the model year end clearance and 2018 introduction at Mark Christopher Auto Center. That means you can consider more car than you anticipated for the money you want to spend. Chevys, Buicks, and GMC trucks. Some Cadillacs are sign and drive deals. As always, it's California's biggest and best selection, and it's never undersold. You'll find Mark Christopher Auto Center right on the 10 Freeway in Ontario, or you can go to markchristopher.com. Mark Christopher is California's number one volume GM dealer, family-owned and doing things right since 1975. Remember, the giant model year-end clearance and vehicle upgrade event is on now at Mark Christopher Auto Center, Vineyard exit of Interstate 10 in Ontario.
It's time to make the Tri-City Center in Redlands a regular part of your weekly shopping experience. Tri-City is home to a wide assortment of quality businesses. Soon, the Tri-City Center will become home to Ocean Aquatics. Ocean Aquatics will offer a wide variety of exotic tropical fish, along with food, accessories, and tanks of all shapes and sizes for every home or business. The Tri-City Center is located just off the I-10 between Alabama and the Tennessee exits in Redlands. Visit the Tri-City Center today and discover why it's called the Mall with a Heart.
When I say Italy, what comes to mind?
Venice.
Capri. Oh my gosh, Capri was marvelous.
The views, the cliffside views, or traveling to Sorrento.
Pirello Tours.
Oh, Pirello Tours, for sure.
Pirello.
Hi, I'm Steve Pirello of Pirello Tours. With over 70 years of tour experience to Italy, it's no wonder Pirello Tours is synonymous with travel to Italy.
I think of the culture.
And to walk up to certain areas and touch a wall and think, well, this wall's like 3,000 years old.
Being on a Pirello Tour on our anniversary was better than anything I can remember ever on an anniversary.
I personally approve every itinerary to ensure a stress-free, once-in-a-lifetime vacation.
Salute!
Call now for your free insider's guide to Pirello's Italy. Call in the next 30 minutes and qualify for a $100 gift card when you travel with us. Call 800-561-3095. 800-561-3095. 800-561-3095.
And now it's time to batten down the hatches, because here comes more of Mark Westwood and On the Mark Live. 3, 2, 1, Mark.
KCAA, 10:50 a.m. And Mark Westwood with you. Just finished up having Scott Welsh from Welsh Insurance Services of Redlands in here. A great conversation, very educational, very interesting. Learned a lot about Medicare and the differences between that and the national health care debate, and how it's really not involved with the national health care debate. This wonderful service that he and his wife offer over here in Redlands. And they are the best insurance company nominated by the San Bernardino County Sun for 2015 and 2017. What's nice about this is it's insurance they're not selling you. It's something you've already been purchasing on your paycheck every day, every week you work, every month you work, every year you work. It's been taken out a little bit at a time. You've already paid for it. It's something that you are given, not given, earned, so you're entitled to it. And I know that's sometimes a bad word, but entitled to at age 65. And they'll help you through that whole process, and that's what their service is about. Sarah and Scott Welsh. So thanks for being here. Well, couldn't let this day pass because it is September 11th, 2017. And a lot of people remember 6 years ago at 9:47 a.m., the terrible tragedy, it still chokes me up a little bit. It's still a tough, bitter pill to have lost all those souls and those people in the World Trade Center. And then since in the battles and wars since then, and all the people that were maimed, you know, it's just very bad. But there's some shining light here that I want to tell you about very quickly before we leave. It's called the Survivor Tree, and it is in Trade Center. It's in One World Trade Center, and it was from the original World Trade Center. It's a calorie pear tree, became known as the Survivor Tree after enduring the September 11, 2001 terror attacks at the World Trade Center. In October 2001, the tree was discovered at Ground Zero, severely damaged with snapped roots and burned and broken branches. The tree was removed from the rubble and placed in the care of the New York City Department of Parks and Recreation. After its recovery and rehabilitation, the tree was returned, very fittingly, to the memorial in 2010 to show a sign of life. As life goes on, new smooth limbs extended from the gnarled stumps, creating a visible demarcation between the tree's past and today's present. Today, the tree stands as a living reminder of resilience, survival, and birth. And how does that relate to us here in San Bernardino and Riverside? Well, especially in San Bernardino, they took seedlings from this tree, and the victims of the tragedies in the two U.S. cities just recently, one of them being San Bernardino and one of them being Orlando, these seedlings were flown to, and also France. They were selected to receive seedlings this year as part of the 911's Memorial Survivor Tree Seedling Program. The communities have committed to nurturing these trees to serve as landmarks, symbolizing resilience and hope. So as we think about those trees, after the 911, the Survivor Tree became a symbol of our country's fortitude, and now it will become a symbol here in this area, the Inland Empire region, especially in San Bernardino, of the terrorist attacks here in San Bernardino, in Orlando, in France, all around the world, really, and in New York City. So we take a moment to pause, to remember, and to reflect on 911. This is Mark Westwood with On the Mark, asking you to step aside, listen to this, and we'll see you after this.
An airplane has hit the World Trade Center, and that's all we know.
Today, we've had a national tragedy.
American Airlines Flight 11 departed Boston for Los Angeles.
Two airplanes have crashed into the World Trade Center.
World Trade Center has been one of their missions.
And then we heard a big bang, and then we saw smoke coming out, and everybody started running out, and we saw the plane on the other side of the building, and there was smoke everywhere, and people were jumping out the window.
And now, if you join me in a moment of silence. Thank you very much. May God bless the victims, their families, and America.
Violence has spread worldwide and there's families on the street.
People are running, their hair on fire. People are jumping out of the World Trade Center. Jumping out because they don't know what to do.
But all we do is eliminate our future. Things we do today. Money is our incentive now, so
reported that my brother John was the captain of American Airlines Flight 11, which was hijacked out of Logan Airport. I keep looking at the cornfield behind me, hoping that my brother comes walking on out.
People were on those planes.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and now 102.3 FM.
I'm Tom Busby, CNBC. A new all-time closing high today for the S&P 500. Stocks surged higher because Hurricane